On today's menu, fish nards. I mean, Shirako.
Romina liked it a lot.
Yeah, I bet.
Across the globe, what's delicious is questionable. Why would you eat that?
Excuse me.
Shirako, which means white children, is a Japanese delicacy made from the milt of pufferfish, or cod. Don't act surprised. It's just a more delicate way of saying sperm sacks, nut butter, your baby fish batter. While not generally known for our delicacy, we'll try to keep this classy. Anywho, the creamy, soft cluster is consumed most often during the winter months, which is when most seminal fluids are in season. In the United States, cod milt is harvested by handsome fishermen at the peak of maturity in December. Once harvested, most of it is exported to Japan, because there's a bigger market there. We might depend on China and Japan to make everything else, but we got them by the bowls when it comes to fish semen. To prepare the Shirako, the milt is removed in its entirety from the fish. It is slippery, white, and bears a striking resemblance to brain, but becomes firmer if cooked. It can be cooked a number of different ways, from fried to make a creamy tempura, or boiled to make a Shirako ponzu, a traditional dish that is buttery and melts in your mouth with a nice finish.
Yes. But why would you eat that?
The eggs, or roe, of underwater creatures are consumed in Europe, Asia, North America, South America, and Oceania. While Shirako, or milt, is less widely noshed on, the Japanese are among those who prize it. It's also high in protein and contains no cholesterol or saturated fat. In fact, those who enjoy it, like my ex, report a sweet, slightly briny taste. But that's what she said about Steve, Rick, Kevin, and Ron, and Charles. I mean, f*** Charles, come on! Whatever, let's feed the office.
Oh, it splattered on me.
Hi, Katie.
That looks really gross.
No.
Oh, I hate this.
What is it?
Is she rocking?
What is that? What language is that?
Japanese.
You're not gonna get it.
No, probably not.
It's like 50 Shades of Georgia over here.
Kinda like it. Okay, I like it. Is that weird?
Do you really?
Yeah.
Romina liked it a lot.
Yeah, I bet.
It's like maybe like tuna that is on the verge of going bad.
Cat food.
It kind of does.
So Shaman's nicer cousin.
It just tastes like tuna fish.
Yeah. Romina said it was kind of buttery.
Buttery?
Very soft.
It smells terrible.
Buttery.
Because it has more of a gelatinous, just more. Oh, come on. You guys are dicks.
It doesn't smell that great, but the texture is wonderful. Why is there crap all over me?
Gelatinous tuna fish, I would say.
I can't hear.
No?
Making me nervous if they won't tell us.
Should I look it up?
Why don't you Google it? Because we're on YouTube.
Wikipedia.
S-H-I-R-A-K-O.
No. Genitalia. Sperm.
Yes, I see. It's sperm.
These are all good keywords that I like to hear when I'm eating food.
Everyone get out.
My job is not to make connections, merely to present facts.
Yeah. I swallowed.
Okay. All right. I didn't even
gross, Mike.
Throw up, Mike.
I apologize.
This is a class show. Next week's our last episode.
Yo.
Yo! Next week is the last Why Would You Eat That for a Good Long Time. Watch as everyone will die someday from natural causes.
Let's take a break from our regularly scheduled promo for a moment of silence for everyone in the office that got mad cow disease from the latest episode of Why Would You Eat That? Okay, now that that's over with, check out the 3-can spam challenge on Stuff. Find out who feeds the fishes afterwards. Wait, did you think I meant someone died? McDonald's giant-sized fries are probably deadly. Check out the story on Food Feature. If there's one thing that makes a party, besides bull testicle beer, of course, it's a good dip. Make this easy drink food recipe. And subscribe for more free, tasted
dishes. Are they done yet? Yes, they are!